Good morning, Knights, and welcome back to the Westmount Highlights. This is our 28th and final episode of the 2021-2022 school year. And this is an episode you will not want to miss. Who doesn't love a clip show? But first, let's take a look at the numbers, shall we? Since we started this channel, we have gained 463 subscribers, racked up 42,460 views, totaling 2,638 total hours viewed. That's a lot of screen time. Yikes. It's been so much fun revisiting the week's events with all of you every Monday. Thank you for allowing myself and the TWH crew into your classrooms and homes throughout the school year. Next year will be a very special year at WHS as we will be celebrating our 150th anniversary in the Westmount community. If you're interested in joining the TWH crew for this upcoming very special school year, please send me an email at mshapiro@emsb.qc.ca. I will also be accepting submissions for a new animated intro and outro. More information to come in the fall. And if you're interested, send me an email and I'll provide you with our special 150th logo to add to your animated submissions. I want to wish you all a wonderful summer break. I'm looking forward to seeing you all in just a few weeks, really. And now let's see what the TWH crew have been cooking up for us this week.
Westmount Highlights is mostly to inform students and teachers about the Daily Bulletin, but in a more entertaining way than how it's usually done.
We also use the Westmount Highlights to share people's insights on things like movies, books, or video games, or even things happening around the world. But not everything goes according to plan.
Okay, so let's get started. Oh, wait a second. Someone is trying to join us. Not sure who this is.
Y'all, hey.
Hey, so sorry. Another hacker.
It's so annoying when people try to hack us. Some people have no lives.
Okay, how's everybody doing today?
Great so far.
Cool. Anybody have any segment ideas?
I'll do another game review.
But you did one last week. I want to do a game review.
I said it first.
Doesn't work like that.
Yeah, look, guys, don't fight, please. And next week is also International Potato Chip Day. We planned on doing a segment about that. Yeah. Whose job was it to have the potato chip prop?
Yeah, there's a slight problem.
Okay, what?
My dog kind of ate all of them.
Come on, dude, you had one job.
I got pretzels.
It's International Potato Chip Day, not pretzels.
Seriously, come on, man.
Yeah, Malachi, you always make this kind of problem.
Okay, guys, look, let's not fight.
I'm really lucky to make some videos for our school, and it's a great honor. But it does take a lot of effort, and there are a lot of mistakes that can happen. Hi, my name is Jingyu. Hi, my name is Jin Liu. Hi, my name is Jin Liu, and this is my music review. Hi, my name is Jin Liu, and this is my music review. Oh, my hair messed up.
Okay, so does everybody know what they need to do?
Who's making that noise?
Yeah, it's so disgusting.
Yeah, seriously, that's disgusting.
Do you think we're blind? We can see you.
Yeah, can you please mute yourself when you eat? Kind of gross.
Malachi is always eating on Zoom. Chips, pretzels. Last week, he was slurping up noodles.
I eat on Zoom. So what?
So, all conflicts aside, what's your favorite part about making the show?
I like watching it in homeroom with my class. I like that my family can see it too.
My favorite part is talking to my friends after the review.
I like making the videos.
My favorite part was beating Tammy Duel in Jeopardy.
What is? No. The color of Tammy Duel's sweater.
Is this a trick question?
I'm gonna say it's gray.
You stupid!
Totally not gray.
After all the hard work, I love seeing the final results.
Well, we thought of a game that would make a very exciting movie. Tetris.
Tetris?
A secret.
Yo, it's me.
It comes with the package. Don't buy this house.
Tell us why you are dating a trash can.
I think that dating a trash can is better than dating anyone else because a trash can is very silent, they're a good listener, they won't leave you, they'll stay with you forever.
Forever.
Okay, the smell won't be good. Introducing this new amazing candy, Cavendi. This unique type of candy is absolutely flavorless.
Oh, tell us more!
Well, this candy is rock hard. So hard, it can even break your teeth. It's really bad for you and it can give you cavities.
How much?
It's only cost $10 per candy. Let's see what people think about this.
You know, editing is actually a master craft. Created in my basement where we put together some clips, right? That's editing.
Okay.
In sports news, congratulations to the WHS Juvenile Soccer Team for winning gold this past Wednesday.
And it's really important to be respectful in our own mind, the ways that we talk to ourselves.
We're all trying to help other people out. We all want to be there for our friends. But part of being there for them is also being there for ourselves and recognizing when maybe we need to take care of ourselves.
Okay, so I just want to congratulate you guys and say you did an amazing job. So give yourself a round of applause. Now this is off unscripted. I don't know if I'll use it. Is there anything anybody wants to say about the highlights, about doing that this year, to Mr. Shapiro, to friends, to a teacher, anything?
Please join. It's fun.
Yes, we need more
join
people.
Us. We need more people. We need an army of people to make videos for us.
It's fun.
It's a great call.
So that's it. That's the season 3 is a wrap. We'll be back next year. And like everyone was saying, let's hope we get more people. If you want to make videos too, if you like making videos, if you want to learn how to make videos, come join us next year. And one more time, I just want to say thanks to everybody for watching and being with us this whole year.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
We also use what's happening.
I'm so bad at this. Sorry, hold on.
That's okay. Maybe we could do a blooper reel on this.
We also use the Westmount highlights for things like... sorry, my bad.
All conflicts is... I see someone is trying to join us. I'm not sure who this is.
Morbius?
Okay, cut. I'm going to do that again. So,
I'll do another game review.
But you did one last week. I want to do a game review.
I did it first!
Said it first. Let's try that again. Okay. Ready?
Yes, here. Oh, sorry, I'm lost. Because there's a big blob.
Let's try it again. Okay, so Malachi, let's do one more take. That was really good. I think one more take and we're good. Is Malachi there?
Yeah, I finished the chips.
Oh, you're all done?
Yeah.
You gotta save some for the... And action.
I like making...
Hello, Westmount High, and welcome to the Westmount Highlights. I'm Ashwin, and this week I'll be reviewing the book Throne of Glass by Sarah J. Maas. Our main character is Selena Seldovia, an 18-year-old assassin who is known across the Empire. One day she was captured for her crimes, and to serve them out, she was sentenced to the salt mines of Evanir. One day, Crown Prince Dorian offers her freedom on one condition. She must act as a champion in the king's competition to choose a new royal assassin. Her opponents are thieves, assassins, and warriors from across the Empire, each sponsored by a different member of the King's Council. If she beats her opponents in a series of illuminations. She'll serve the kingdom for 4 years and then gain, be granted her freedom. But soon, one of the contestants turns up dead, and then another. Can Selena figure out who's the killer before she becomes a victim? As the young assassin investigates, her search leads her to become an even greater conspiracy than she believed was at play. Well, that's it for now, folks. Thanks for tuning into this week's Westmount Highlights, and I'll see you after the summer break.
Hey guys, I have some pretty sad news. Matthew, depression. He was concerned that, well, if you've seen any other review of this movie, you'd know exactly what we're dealing with here. He was concerned that no movie would ever be good again because of just how perfect Morbius was. As I was looking through my gallery at the folder of Matthew picks that I have, I found a pre-recorded review of Morbius that he did. Here it is.
Hey guys, just another day of coping with this movie. You know, I've never felt the same way about cinema, about life. I've been having these episodes lately where my body just starts seizing up when I think about how glorious Morbius was. It was so good. I don't even remember what the movie was about. I don't even remember Morbius. Morbius crying!
So yeah, Matthew's review was pretty much accurate. The only thing I would change is Matthew forgot to mention that our cinema experience was unlike any other. There was not one sound from the crowd. No cheers. No laughs. No crunches of popcorn. Doesn't that just sound like an amazing cinema experience? To add on to that, there was nobody else in the theater. We were the only people in that theater. Isn't that just amazing? As the most perfect movie after Shark Tale, it follows the story of Dr. Michael Morbius, who is played by Dr. Michael Morbius. And he is a doctor who gets morbed through the movie. This movie morbed me. I am now officially a morber. There are two big mysteries in life. When will the producers stop? What are their limitations? They made this masterpiece. When will they stop? I hope it's never. The second big mystery is Obama's last name.
One more thing, I just can't stop thinking about what happens to Michael Morbius after he morbs. It's just so incredible. It's awe-inspiring, the morbliscles that he can produce.
Well, guys, that was my review and Matthew's review, obviously. May he forever rest in peace. That was our review of Dr. Michael Morbius's new biopic, Morbius. I hope you guys enjoyed, and please have a nice life. Oh, and one last thing. I gotta tell you guys what my most anticipated film of the future is. I guess you guys can guess, obviously. Shark Tale 2.
And that's it for us this year. We'll be back in the fall with another season of the Westmount Highlights. Until then, we'll keep the nightlights on. Be well. Yeah.